Yeah. Let's take a ride. Madison Bus, it serves as a reality check for miles 6,000 to 800 West. The reality of the situation, the reality of our situation, is a community is, has been, dying. A community that looks like a pop-pop-pop-pop-pop post-apocalyptic war zone. Colonized, gentrified, sodomized. All this is seen through the windows of the Madison Bus. A lot of times, the bus drivers take their sweet-ass time. Almost like they're driving a tour bus or something.
To your right, ladies and gentlemen, we have the urban North American Negro man in his natural habitat, standing on a corner with his brains and masculinity in the palm of his hand.
I swear if I had a penny for every brother I seen waste away on Madison, I could buy the motherfucking West Side. I watch people riding, staring out the windows, faces blank, devoid of any visible signs of recognition, indignation, infuriation, nothing. I wonder what they do see when they ride the Madison bus. I dream big. When I ride and watch, I see locations for schools, hospitals, theaters, homes. I see opportunities for us to gentrify our own communities. I see men, women, and children who have heard so many death tolls. The ears have grown deaf anticipating hearing freedom ring. Yeah, a whole hell of a lot of people need to ride the Madison bus. Clarence Thomas, Shelby Steele, Oprah Winfrey, Bill Father knows best fantasy having ass Cosby. My sister Kamini says there are those who need to take a hot bath in the bowels of the people. The Madison bus. The Madison bus. The Madison bus. The Madison bus rushing through the bowels of the people. Faster than a hot water enema. Yeah, more people do need to ride the Madison bus. 6,000 to 800 West. More people need to ride the Madison bus. So why don't they?